So now I'm ready to actually talk to you. Former First Lady, Mrs. Mbeki, distinguished guests, hello, welcome, thank you for coming. It's wonderful to see you all. It is my honor and my pleasure to be here today, courtesy of the Thabo Mbeki Foundation's recognition of International Women's Day 2017. I say a big thank you to the Foundation for bringing me to Johannesburg and bringing me together with yourselves and also the amazing people that I met at dinner last night at the Foundation. I thank all of you for giving up your time to be here because you are passionate about activism, about women, and about Africa, and also because you are passionate about what happens when we put those three together. I think one of the reasons why I am here this evening is that I've dedicated a fair amount of my professional life to issues that affect women, and being an African woman myself, to issues that affect African women. I am pleased that we are talking specifically about African women's activism because, to my mind, we do not make this specification often enough. Too often, we talk generally about women, women's development, women's this, women's that. And in this context, African women end up with the status of the poor sister. I know this does not sound very cheerful, but I came to a conclusion that surprised me as I went over material in preparation for this evening. This conclusion that I came to is that African women's activism is alive and kicking. So I'm going to give you my definition of activism. After that, I'm going to look at women's activism. Then I'm going to put the Africa, mix all that in. So we look at African women's activism, see where that takes us. And then I'll come to some of my conclusions. So you've been warned. I escaped academia, and I'm winging it. Okay, so what am I talking about when I say African women's activism? I think African women's activism can be a perplexing and sometimes even threatening concept for people who are not engaged with this activism as their core business. Each of the concepts in that phrase, African women's activism, is huge. So I'm breaking it down, term by term. How are we doing with the slides? Yes? Thank you, thank you. A definition of activism that I find useful is the following. Activism is vigorous actions carried out in an effort to promote, impede, or redirect social, political, economic, and or environmental reform or stasis. You might want to push something, or you might also want to stop something happening. And this is done with the desire to make improvements in society. This definition is a combination of several others. You have them up there. I won't go through, you can look at them yourselves as I speak. But coming back now to how I have put these three definitions together, I want to pull out some of the aspects of that definition that are particularly important to me. You'll see that in my definition, I prefer to emphasize action rather than doctrine. In fact, I've even made it plural, not talking about action, but talking about actions. For me, this is important mentally because it implies that activism is something ongoing and not a once-off event. Now, there are many people, even like myself, we can remember engaging in this one big thing and we have nostalgia about it. But for me, activism should be something that we continue to engage with in the different phases of our life. By emphasizing action, I also take activism out of the realm of the theoretical into the practical. I know we're going to have huge discussions about this, and I'm just putting it out there in order to stimulate some reactions and some debate. So, I want to take activism out of the realm of the theoretical and into the practical. I think you have seen this happening in South Africa. Was it at Rhodes University, Grahamstown, where the young women were learning about gender and all these issues, but they had to come out when there was the issue of alleged rapists being in class with the same people. I'm saying we need to concentrate on that transition that brings us out of the headspace into the body space, actually doing things. Of course, I don't deny the importance of theory. Theory may be necessary for the planning of activism, but activism itself requires practice. Another important aspect of activism is that the actions have to be vigorous. I'm going to ask a question, and I hope I get some answers on this without people being offended. Are African women vigorous? Okay. All right, so you get the point. And you know, I'm going to just touch on, I haven't got time, reasons why maybe people are not as vigorous as they would like to be. But we have to understand that if we want to be activists, we do have to find that source that enables us to be vigorous. The requirement for vigorous action brings us to the requirement for commitment when engaging in activism. I'm going to show you a little trailer that illustrates what I mean when I say there can be no true activism without commitment. It is the trailer to the film Suffragettes that one of the organizations I work with, called Women Filmmakers of Zimbabwe, prepared for the International Images Film Festival for Women. This is a festival that screens inspiring films about women, and we do this so vigorously that we have